Hey everybody, welcome back. Jordan here. Today we're going to be taking a look at three different brand new LEGO Star Wars sets that are going to be released globally here on August 1st in 2021. We have the Imperial Light Cruiser from The Mandalorian, Boba Fett Starship, also known as the Slave One, and that's also from The Mandalorian, and also the Imperial Armored Marauder. All of these sets come with some fantastic minifigures, and it's a pretty sweet lineup. We're going to start by taking a look at the largest one, which of course is the Imperial Light Cruiser, which is also Moff Gideon's ship. It's LEGO set 75315, and it's going to retail for $160. This ship was mainly found in Season 2, and you can actually use it to recreate some of the epic hero versus villain battles. And this is the first ever brick-built model of the Imperial Light Cruiser. It includes five amazing LEGO Star Wars minifigures. That includes the Mandalorian, Cara Dune, Fennec Shand, Moff Gideon, and a new for August 2021 Dark Trooper, plus a LEGO figure of the Child, or Grogu. So the Starship is pretty cool. It actually features a bridge that doubles as a handle for flying, two rotating turrets with spring-loaded shooters, two mini TIE fighters, and also a launcher for those two TIE fighters, plus a hatch to access the cabin. The hatch is pretty sweet. Essentially, the whole front half of the ship will sort of lift up. That exposes the entire bridge and the area where you can place your minifigures to create some pretty neat scenes. Also in the hatch is a little storage spot where you can stow away one of your bullets for the spring-loaded shooter. So yeah, pretty sweet list of minifigures. Also, these minifigures come with some pretty cool weapon elements and accessories as well. This includes the Mandalorian's Phase Pulse Blaster and also the spear, which is made from the Beskar. However, I think this one is made of plastic. Moff Gideon also comes with his dark saber, although with that said, it's just a standard lightsaber hilt with a dark blade. There's not an actual new piece that they made to represent the dark saber. You also get two thermal detonators and a pair of binoculars. The Light Cruiser itself is quite large. It's 5 inches or 13 centimeters high, 22.5 inches or 58 centimeters long, and also 8.5 inches or 22 centimeters wide. Overall, I think this 1,336-piece set is pretty awesome. We've never gotten a Imperial Light Cruiser before. It looks pretty detailed, pretty accurate. Also, it has that nice handle in which you can pick it up with. And the minifigures come with some pretty neat accessories. Although I would have liked to see a new piece that represents the Darksaber. The Imperial Light Cruiser is the largest of the three sets that we're going to be having a look at today. The next one is actually Boba Fett's Starship, or the Slave One. This one here is going to retail for $50 in the United States, and it has 593 pieces. It's LEGO set 75312. Once again, all of these sets are going to be available on August 1st here in 2021. So we all know that we saw the Slave One back in action in the second season of The Mandalorian, and it was included in some epic battle scenes. So of course, this set here, you get two different LEGO Star Wars minifigures, that being Boba Fett and also The Mandalorian. You also get a little carbonite brick to add to the creative play possibilities of the set. The Boba Fett minifigure is epic. He comes with his blaster, also his torso piece is very highly detailed, as it has the arm print detailing, and also his legs have some print detailing on them as well. And the Mandalorian comes with his blaster rifle, and once again we see that Beskar spear, and he is very highly detailed with some awesome print detailing on his helmet, torso, arms, and legs. The Starship has a handle for easy flying, an open LEGO minifig cockpit, rotating wings. Looks like it's got a couple stud shooters on either side just behind the cockpit there, and then it's got two rotating blasters on the back of the ship as well. However, the ones on the back are just for show. They will not actually shoot. As always, it looks like they nailed the shape of the Slave One, although they are probably getting pretty good at it as they've recreated this model quite a few different times. Also in the back of the ship, you can see that there is a compartment for the carbonite brick that comes with the ship. The carbonite brick, I believe, will just be a sticker element like we saw in the Razor Crest. It's not an actual Han Solo style carbonite piece, which is sort of lame, but it is what it is. I really do like that Han Solo carbonite piece though, but I guess if you want to get one of those, you got to get the UCS Slave One or the 20th Anniversary Slave One. This set here also includes a transport vehicle to move the Starship on the ground in play scenarios. And at first glance, I thought, well, that's not really necessary. We don't really need that. Maybe they're just doing that to make it more so a playset. But then when I actually saw this photo up here, I realized that this little transport vehicle can be used as a stand. So therefore, this Slave One can actually be stood upright when it's on your display, similar to the UCS one, whereas the 20th anniversary one actually lacked that display feature. So this is actually a nice added feature to the set. The Starship measures 3.5 inches or 8 centimeters high, and both in height and width, it's 8 inches or 20 centimeters. Overall, I mean, I think we've got enough slave ones, although I do understand why they did this one, because it is more of a Mandalorian set. So it sort of appeals to a different market. Also, you get some really cool minifigures in there. I'm not really complaining. Am I going to get it? I'm not sure. I already have 2 slave ones, but yeah, I'll probably get it. So that's Boba Fett Starship, or the slave one. Overall, I think it looks pretty good. You get the 2 minifigures. You know, it's been done before, but it looks pretty fantastic. Pretty on point, which is pretty typical for the slave one sets. Next up, our third set is the Imperial Armored Marauder, which is set 75311. This one here is 478 pieces, and it's gonna retail for $40 in the United States. I don't know, is this sort of like their take on the new battle pack, right? $40 price point, comes with a pretty big vehicle, but we also get 4 minifigures, 3 of which are stormtroopers. So we get Grief Karga with a blaster pistol, and then we get 2 standard stormtroopers with blasters, and also a new for August 2021 artillery stormtrooper with a mortar gun and a backpack accessory element. I really do like that stormtrooper there. The artillery stormtrooper has like that yellow detailing, also an additional accessory going over top of his right shoulder there, and a backpack. I do appreciate how these are, you know, like the classic stormtroopers. I much prefer that over the First Order Stormtroopers, which is Disney. Of course, these are going to be the classic ones because this is, once again, a set that is from The Mandalorian. The Marauder model has 4 stud shooters, including 2 on the rotating rear turret, 2 fold-out blaster cannons, a Lego minifigure cockpit, and a cabin for 2 Lego minifigures. It also has a lookout point with an opening hatch where you can see Grief Karga sort of popping out there. Also on the side of the Marauder, you can see a couple ammo compartments there. 1 minifigure coming out the side. The ammo compartment is just in behind. And on the front of the ship, it looks like there's a little slot there for minifigures to view out of the Marauder. This set here measures 3 inches or 8 centimeters tall, 7.5 inches or 19 centimeters long, and 4 inches or 10 centimeters wide. Overall, I'd be looking at this set for the minifigures. I want to get more stormtroopers. Got 100 of them, but probably need 100 more. Also, I really like the mortar stormtrooper. Pretty neat. And the Grief Karga actually has a really nice torso piece and leg piece. Also, I like his head as well. He's got like some white stubble on his face. So yeah, overall, some great minifigures in this set here. A reasonable price point of $40 US, and you get a pretty cool vehicle out of it as well. Will I be getting this one? Probably, because that new Stormtrooper with the yellow print detailing looks epic. Am I going to get a fleet of them? Probably not. So that's the 3 brand new LEGO Star Wars sets that are coming out here on August 1st in 2021. We've got the Imperial Armored Marauder, the Slave One, and also the Imperial Light Cruiser. Let me know what you think of these sets by commenting below. Remember to like, subscribe, and stay tuned for some more great stuff here coming out on the channel. Peace out.